Hello and welcome to my art studio on wheels. My name is Chrissy and I'm an illustrator and graphic designer from Germany. Today I'm drawing the second picture of the beautiful color book from Maria Trolle. I decided this time that I will color the pictures in this book in such a way that they always show a night scenery. So there will be a lot of small light sources, or the moon will be the light source. And in this case, the rabbit will be the light sources. So that means these are glowing rabbits. It is kind of a challenge because there are so many of them that I hardly can draw shadows, but I will try my best. As you see here, I define a circle around the rabbit in which I draw no color. And around each and every rabbit I have to make a circle, which I leave whether white or blue, because I want them to shine in such a bluish colors. I also ordered white gel pens. I hope they arrive in time, because I want to try how to add light with a gel pen. Here I layer the color again. So first I started with a light green, now a darker green, and in the end I will go over it with a black. Here I start drawing here and there some shadows into the hair. Since the rabbits are making a white bluish shine on the face of this fairy, I leave two parts white, left and right parts of the chin. I leave them white. You will later on see that this will really give this effect of a glow on that chin. Now I try to figure out where the shadows are. Remember that the light source comes from below. So there are shadows beneath the hair, above the eyes, and a little bit also beneath the chin. Although the light sources are coming from under the chin, from below the chin. But still, I will make this a little bit at least a shadow there. Thank you. As you see, I leave some parts of the hair white, which gives it a shiny look. The eyes I make green, and I leave one white spot as a lightning. In each eye. The surrounding of the rabbits I leave completely white or light blue, so that it is clear that they are quite a strong light source. I think later on I will go into it with white acrylics also, or with the white gel pen, let's see. But maybe the white acrylics are the better option. It's a little bit difficult this time because it's so many rabbits, so many lights, and actually light you can show in a picture much better through shadow than through light, and I find it hard to find spots where I draw shadow, because when I finish one rabbit and then I think, ah, here I can make shadow, and then I think, oh no, there's the next rabbit coming and it's again glowing. So I tried to find spots where to draw with black, but I got more and more brave to go in with black, and then it was fine. Thank you. As you see here, I'm drawing around every rabbit a circle, which is demonstrating where the light is going. I'm not completely following the circle sometimes, but it is like approximately in this area there's only light. As you see on every leaf and every flower, I leave white spots. This is the glowy shine of the rabbit. So from this flower, for example, the glowy shine comes from two sides, left and right, from the left and right rabbit. And here with this leaf, the shine comes from above. So above I leave a white edge. Actually, the background is black, but I leave the background around the rabbits white because they have a white shine around them. But I'm not completely convinced that this is the right decision, so I will just finish it like this, and then I will try it with one rabbit that I fill out the background in black and make the highlights only with a gel pen or with acrylics, white acrylics. So let's see. Here I let the black fade out into the white. But as I said, maybe I filled it later on also with black. Now I try to give the hair as much shadow as possible, because as I said, you just show the presence of light for best in drawing shadows. I am doing this really, really soft, and I'm always thinking, where are the holes? And where is it engraved? Where is shadow? Where's the shadow parts? Obviously, never forget the light source, no? Means the shadows must be illogical.
Thank you.
I decided to draw over the whole drawing with the blue pencil. Actually, everywhere except the glowing circles around the rabbits. Also, her face should be in the shadow. As the gel pens unfortunately didn't arrive yet, I decided to draw everything with a brush and acrylics. Finally, the ball pen, the gel pen, arrived. It's a little bit too late because I don't need it anymore, but I think I give it a try at least on one corner. Maybe here. Oh, that's quite nice. I think from now on I only will use this because it's so hard to make thin lines with a brush. Actually, I don't need a light there, but I just try it. Nice. Actually, before I used the acrylics, I wanted to make white sprinkles around the rabbits as a light source, but now I see it looks quite nice if I make it over the acrylic painting. Very cute. It looks like stardust around them. Okay, that was it for today. I hope you liked it, and if you have color books on your own which you like or which would you recommend, then write me in the comments and like and subscribe. Don't forget.